Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a fantastic day as usual. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you my best luxury purchases in 2021. These are all the items that I purchased in 2021, but these are my favorites. So I'm not going to be sharing every single item I purchased. I just crafted a list of my favorites. So out of everything I purchased, these are the items that I'm really, really happy that I purchased. I've been getting a lot of use out of them and I would highly, highly recommend them. So if that sounds like something you guys would be interested in, make sure to hit that little subscribe button and I'd love to have you stick around. So without further ado, let's get right into my 2021 best luxury purchases. Okay guys, so I have to be honest, after looking at all of the items, I was a bad girl this year. I don't have any excuses whatsoever other than the fact is I love investing my money in handbags and small leather goods, but I was a bad girl. It was probably a little excessive, so let's promise to make this video a judgment-free zone. We are all luxury lovers. That's why you guys are here, right? So let's go over my luxury purchases. These are the items that I absolutely love. And if I don't mention something that I purchased, that doesn't mean that I didn't love it this year, but these are out of everything. These are like my go-tos. Like these are the ones I am so incredibly happy that I purchased, and you will see why. So let's go ahead, let's get right into it. I'm gonna go in the order that I purchased these items, starting with my Chanel birthday haul. Back in January, you guys know that I turned 40 in January, and I treated myself to my dream color. And it is my Chanel mini rectangular in the oh so pretty. It's a light blue. That's the actual color. But this is the most beautiful Tiffany blue color. I fell in love with this. Now, I did have to buy this pre-loved because I did miss out on the Cruise collection. This one right here is from the Cruise 2019 collection. And I bought it from a lovely girl named Lauren. She just wasn't really using it. And I got a really, really good deal on it. I'm so glad I added it to my collection. I don't have another rectangular mini, so it is just beautiful. I mean, look at this color. It has the silver hardware. It has the grommets on the top, so the chain goes all the way through. And I'm going to open it for you and show you. Right now, I do have a Zumoni organizer, but let me go ahead and let me take the organizer out so you can see what the interior of this bag looks like. So this is just a single flap, and you can see the interior there. I keep the authenticity card on the inside, and this one right here is a 27 series, and the color is light blue, and this is from the 19C collection. Oh my gosh, let me count the ways that I love this bag. Not only is it beautiful to look at, it's a tiny little thing, but it fits quite a bit. I like to wear this as a long shoulder. I like to wear this as a crossbody. My favorite way to wear this is as a pop of color. So obviously I like to maybe wear a white dress. I've worn this with a yellow dress. It just pairs so nicely. It is so beautiful. If you don't want to wear it with a dress, you could wear it with a nice pair of jeans or a white top. It is just so pretty. Now, we'll be mindful there is a little bit of color transfer on the back, but it's not a huge, huge deal to me. I just could not resist this color. It is so stunning and it definitely fits a lot. If you guys are interested in this bag and you want more details, check out my video section. I have done a ton of videos. I have done a what's in my bag so you can see what fits, but this is a great little bag. I love the color. And if you guys know me, you know how much I love turquoise, and this was just the perfect, perfect 40th birthday gift. I am just in love with it. Okay, sticking with my 40th birthday haul, another item that I picked up is this little beauty right here. This is the Chanel small cosmetic pouch, or some people call it the mini O case, and I just love this color. Again, it's in the color light blue. This one is from the Cruise 2020 collection. So you can see the colors are just a tad off, but they work. And I love this piece right here because it is caviar leather, but it's really, really thin. So not only is it durable, it fits in a lot of bags and it fits a ton of items. I typically use it for cash and receipts. I also throw some coins in there. You can see the interior. It is just an absolutely beautiful piece. I have done an Instagram reel showing you the different ways to use it. There are so many different ways. I just love this. I also own it in black. It's one of my favorite small leather goods for sure. And I'm so happy I was able to pick it up in this beautiful, beautiful Tiffany blue. Okay, the next item that I want to mention is also from my Chanel birthday haul. There was a theme to my 40th birthday haul. It was turquoise because you guys know my obsession with turquoise. And it is this little guy right here. This right here is the Chanel coin purse. And again, it is in the color light blue, and it is from the Cruise 2020 collection. And I love this one because it has a pocket on the outside. So this is where you can put your ID. I actually have, oh my God, gosh, you guys, I have been looking for my Nordstrom credit card and here it was. So, oh, I just found it. Nice. I thought I was going to have to call and cancel it, but it was right there. So anyway, there is a pocket right here, which is nice because you can use it for your ID or an important credit card. Love that. And then on the inside, it has an accordion style. So there are three slots. So you guys know me, I am a big card person. I have a lot of like store credit cards. So I like these type of wallets here where it has the accordion style where it will expand and you can fit quite a few cards. And this does that. This one right here is a 29 series. It is just beautiful. And this one is made in Spain. You can see the interior, but I love these pieces. I really do. And I'm so glad that I was able to get it in this beautiful light blue color. Okay, the next bag I want to mention, I was so thrilled to add this to my collection. And I'm gonna be honest, I never thought this was a bag that I would add to my collection, and you'll see what I'm talking about when I share it with you, but it is the Palm Springs mini backpack. Now, I have never been like a mini backpack type of gal, but I first saw this on Maria Vizuet or Mia Mia Mine on Instagram. She wore this as a crossbody bag, and I said, oh my gosh, that looks like so cute and chic as a crossbody. Plus, I love that it had a top handle. And then you can see on the back, it comes with two straps here. I will usually wear it as a crossbody, so I'll take one of these straps off and I'll either just use the black, or one way I really like to wear it is I like to attach my Pochette Matisse strap to this, and it fits so much. I love how it fits. You open up the zipper. It's a very smooth zipper. And I just will place my things in here vertically, and it's very, very easy to pull things out of it. This is just a great, great bag. My only complaint with this bag really is I don't really use this pocket because it's very difficult to get into. Some people have mentioned that they will get the strap, the chains that you can attach from zipper to zipper, and it will help you open it a little bit. But because of this flap, it's just a little cumbersome to get into, but you can put things in it. You can put like a card, you can put like a lipstick, but I just don't really ever use this. But other than that, I love the way it looks crossbody. It is so unique and different. And I'm really, really happy that I added this bag to my collection. So cute. I was actually torn between the monogram or the reverse monogram, but I'm actually glad I got the monogram because I feel like for my style and for my wardrobe, it matches a little better, and I'm just so happy I picked it up. Okay, the next bag I want to mention, this is number 5 on the list, and it is my Louis Vuitton Neverfull in the MM size. I was so lucky to score this prior to the price increase. I think I got this for around $1,500, or maybe it was under $1,500. I can't remember. But I love the Neverfull. You guys know that I own the GM size, which is ideal for travel, but the MM size is ideal for an everyday tote. It's a great work bag. Again, I have it in the damier bin with the beautiful rose ballerine interior. I do once again have a Zumoni organizer on the inside. I love that it also comes with a little pouch. I've mentioned before, you can use this to house your makeup, or you can use this as a little clutch. So many uses for this bag, but this fits quite a bit. I did do a dedicated video to this, kind of sharing with you the positives and the negatives. And you'll have to excuse me about the lighting. I'm sitting in front of a window, and so it's kind of going in and out. So I apologize if it gets a little lighter and then darker and lighter and then darker. All part of filming, but we'll go with it. We'll work with it. But yeah, if you want to know more about this bag, definitely check out that video. As I stated, I share with you the positives and the negatives, and my recommendation, I share with you what fits. It is a great great tote. It really, really is, and I'm so blessed that I was able to pick it up. Okay, the next item I want to mention is a small leather good, and it is a wish list item, and it is my Louis Vuitton. This is the Mini Pochette in the Escal collection. You guys know that I wanted this for the longest time, but I was not able to get it in store, so I did have to buy it on the pre-loved market. I bought it from the Fashion File website, so I paid a little bit of a premium. It wasn't too bad, but I got it brand new, so I was happy about that. But you can see it has the beautiful pastel colors. It has the Louis Vuitton big logo on the back. This is the silver hardware, and these mini pochettes are amazing because they have so many uses. You can use them to store your makeup. You have like receipts in there, cash. You can attach another chain on here if you want to make it like a longer crossbody bag. And this one is so beautiful because it has like the beautiful periwinkle interior. I love these mini pochettes. I have three of them. I have one in monogram, one in the Damier Eben, and then I wanted to add this beautiful color to my collection. This is so me. I love color and pastels, and I was just obsessed with this collection. So beautiful. This one right here is made in France. I'm not sure if you guys can see that right there, but I just love this little guy. It is so beautiful to look at, and it's such a nice little treat when I look in my purse and I see these beautiful colors. Okay, next on the list, I want to mention a bag, and shocker, shocker, it is a YSL camera bag. I was on the hunt for a summer bag, and you guys know how much I love the camera bag. So when I saw the Raffia camera bag, I was just in love. So in case you guys aren't familiar with my style, the summer months, I love to wear a lot of dresses, and with dresses, I like to wear straw bags. And so when I saw this Raffia style bag, I'm like, oh my gosh, this is gonna pair perfectly with my summer wardrobe. It comes with this little tassel. The back, you can see here. A lot of you have asked me about color transfer. I have not had any issues. It has a long adjustable strap. I just love this. And then this bag fits a ton. Once again, just like my other bags, I have done a dedicated video on this. So if you guys want to know more about this bag, make sure to check that video out, especially like if you want to see what fits. It fits so much. I am so amazed at how much the camera bag fits. It really, really does. I love it so much. Unfortunately, as of today, a lot of the camera bag prices have increased. I think YSL is kind of trying to keep up with the likes of Louis Vuitton and Chanel. It's unfortunate, but YSL is still one of my favorite brands. I love this bag, and it is just the perfect summer bag. Okay, the next item I want to mention is a small leather good, and it is the Rosalie. This is from the Louis Vuitton Wild at Heart collection, and it is so beautiful. It is black, and then it has the pops of pink and yellow animal print. You know how much I love the Rosalie, so when I saw this was coming out, I knew I had to have it. This is just such a perfect little compact wallet. It really is. Just like I mentioned with the Chanel coin purse, I am a person who loves a lot of cards, so this wallet is perfect because it has a little zip compartment in which you can put some coins. Then there is this accordion style right here where you can put cards, and then there is a compartment back here in which you can put cash. I have done reels on this. I've also done dedicated videos. I just love this. I have mentioned that the Rosalie is probably one of my favorite compact wallets. I just can't say enough good things about it. So when I saw that they were coming out with the Rosalie in a special collection, I knew I had to add it, and I'm so glad I did. I just love the combination of the black and the pink and the yellow. It's so beautiful. Okay, next let's talk about a bag that I purchased this year that has been one of the most functional purchases, most functional bags ever, and it was such a nice surprise, and it was the Odeon PM. So I have the Odeon PM in the Damier Eben with the beautiful black. I almost got it in the monogram, but they sold out of that one, so I'm actually really glad I got it in the Damier Eben because I have a lot of monogram bags, you know, the Bichette Matisse, I have the Palm Springs Mini, I have the Lucky BB, and this one is just different, and there's something about the combination of the Damier Eben with the black. It's so beautiful. I love this luggage tag. It is such a nice little addition to the bag, and my favorite is this pocket. I love this pocket. So useful, so functional. That's where I put my phone. The bottom of the bag, you can see that. It has little black leather corners. You can remove the strap. The strap is very hardy. It is adjustable. I typically wear it as a crossbody. I've worn this bag so much. It has a zipper that some of you ask if it zips all the way across, and it does. You can see the interior of the bag is black. That is my one complaint with this bag. I wish they would have made the interior of this bag red or even a beige color, because sometimes it is a little bit hard to see your things. That is one complaint I have, not a huge deal, but I wish they would have made the interior red, very similar to the Alma BB. But other than that, this bag has been, I would say out of everything I purchased this year, this has been one of the most functional bags. I love this. Can't recommend it enough. If you guys are able to get your hands on it, I highly recommend it. I love the monogram in the black, but there is something different about the Demi Hebdomadaire in the black. It's just a beautiful combination. Love the luggage tag. You can remove the luggage tag if you want, but I like the luggage tag. I think it just spruces the bag up a little bit, and I'm so glad I added this to my collection. The next item is something that you guys are probably tired of hearing about, because I think I've mentioned this a lot recently. And it is my little Gucci, this is my little Gucci key pouch. I love this. This has been such a nice surprise. You guys are probably well aware, Minx For All is probably the main YouTuber that made this famous. She would rave about it, and she is so right. It's so good. I purchased this, I want to say, a month or two ago, and I've been using it nonstop ever since. I was looking for something a little bit smaller. Like you can see, here's the mini pochette. I wanted something a little smaller that could fit in all of my handbags, and this may look tiny, but boy, does it fit a lot. So first, let's go over the features. It has a little D-ring. It's very shiny, so you can attach your keys if you like. You can see the bottom, the back. But right now, I use it for like hand sanitizer, lipstick, perfume. I have some marshmallow pumpkin latte hand sanitizer. I have some little Chanel lip balm in boy. I have a little Chanel Gardenia perfume, and then I have my ever so popular Baccarat Rouge that I talk about like 100 times all the time on my channel. I just love it. So this is so great. If you don't want to use it for makeup, you can use cash, receipts, attach your keys. The possibilities are endless, but I have really been loving this, and it has just been one of those really, really useful purchases. And let's face it, I mean, obviously, if you invest the money in things like this, you want them to be functional, but sometimes when we invest in things like this, they aren't always that functional, and this, I have found, is great. I think you can only get it in store now, but I will try to find something similar and link it down below, but it is just, oh, such a good piece. I love it. Okay, we are getting down to the wire. I have two more items to share. The next item is another camera bag. It is my recent YSL tweed camera bag. Oh, how beautiful. When I added this to my collection, it was my fourth camera bag. Do you need four camera bags? No, you don't, but I have a love affair with this bag, and I could not resist the tweed. It is so beautiful. Look at all the beautiful colors. You guys know me, I love to wear a lot of color. And I just love pairing this with a pair of black pants and a pop of color for a top. I think it looks really cute. And I've mentioned before that it kind of resembles Christmas lights, so I think this is gonna be nice for the holidays. You know, you wear it with, I have like a red coat I can pair it with. You can wear it with a black coat. The options are endless. This one does have the typical little tassel, and it does have the adjustable strap, and I will put pictures in so you can see what it looks like on me. Just like the other camera bag, it has a very sizable compartment. It fits a lot. I have recently done a What's in My Bag, so if you guys like What's in My Bag videos, make sure to check that out. You would be amazed to see what fits in this bag. It is so much, but love this bag. This is one of my more recent purchases, and I'm so glad I did, because it is perfect for the winter months and the holidays. And so far, I've worn it quite a bit, and the tweed has held up pretty well. I have a couple little spots where it looks like the tweed is kind of getting little fuzzies, but other than that, holding up nicely. And I just think it's very unique, and I'm really happy I added it to my collection. Okay, we are down to the last item, and this was probably the most special item to me that I purchased this year. So I went in order of purchases for most of my items, except I did go a little out of order for this one. I saved this one for last because I would say out of all my purchases this year, this was by far the most special. And it's because I saved and saved and saved for this one. Of course, I saved for all of my bags, but this one was extra special. I had never invested in a bag that is this expensive before. And it meant a lot to me to save my money and buy this bag for myself. And I did that, and I'm very, very excited about it. And it is the Chanel Jumbo. Ugh. I still, when I look at this bag, I just am in awe of the beauty. I have it in the caviar leather, the gold hardware. You have the beautiful chain. Oh, it is so pretty. And then on the back, it has this sizable Mona Lisa pocket. It is so durable, so beautiful. I was blessed for so many reasons with this bag. Not only was I blessed that my sales associate was able to get it for me, but I was also blessed that I was able to get it before the price increase. Would you guys believe me if I told you? Since I purchased this bag, which was just a few months ago, the bag has gone up. Are you ready for this? Take a deep breath. Like $3,000. I could not believe it, and I just kept thanking my lucky stars. I mean, let's not even get into the Chanel price increases. They are absolutely crazy, and I'm not saying that I'm never gonna buy from Chanel again, but it just, when I take a look at the brand now, I just kind of think to myself, I don't know if I even really want to pay that price. But I'm so glad to have this bag. It is a double flap. And I was torn when getting this bag if I wanted to get the double flap in stores or if I wanted to get the single flap on the pre-loved market. And I opted for the double flap just because I did a lot of research and I read that the structure just holds a little better in the double flap. And that's one thing I love about this bag is the structure. But anyway, you can see the interior. I do have an organizer, a Zumoni organizer in here. This bag right here is a 31 series. Oh, you guys, I'm so blessed to have this. I really, really love this. And just like I've mentioned with the other videos, with the other bags, I have done a dedicated video on this in case you have any questions about the Jumbo, I kind of break it down for you. But like I said, I wanted to save this bag for last because out of all the bags I purchased, they're all special to me. This is the one that was probably the most special because I really, really saved and I worked really, really hard to purchase this for myself. And I'm just so happy I was able to get it, especially before the price increase. Oh, before the price increase. So there you have it, you guys. Those are my best luxury purchases for 2021. I'm really, really happy with the items that I picked up. If you guys are interested in any of these, I will try to find them and link them down below on the pre-loved market. If you are new to my channel, make sure to hit that little subscribe button, and I'd love to have you follow me on Instagram as well. And stay tuned, you guys. I have a lot of really, really fun and exciting videos coming, so make sure you turn on the notifications so you don't miss any new videos from me. Have a wonderful day, you guys, and I'll see you in my next video.